For thousands of years, people told stories of blackfish, king of the underworld, a symbol of power and strength, a formidable predator, to be regarded with fear, awe, and reverence, the orca. As time and man has evolved, the heavy pressure on marine resources has caused many populations to become threatened. But I've come to the Arctic Circle in stunning northern Norway to learn more about a unique population that seemed to be growing and thriving, the North Atlantic killer whales.
I finally made it to northern Norway in the Arctic Circle. And today I'm going out with a super experienced, knowledgeable and ethical captain called Jonas Beyer. And hopefully we'll get a glimpse of the North Atlantic killer whales.
The sea conditions can be extremely rough here. The water is cold and dark and the wind is harsh. But every year, November through to January, one of the largest gatherings of killer whales in the world happens within these fjords. Over 1,400 known individuals belonging to this population show up for one thing, the herring. Their bodies are exposed to extremely cold temperatures, and like us, they're warm-blooded. But to make sure they can thermoregulate in these conditions, they rely heavily on their blubber, a thick layer of tissue that provides insulation and energy storage. This is why making sure they get enough food is vital for their survival.
For me, there's nothing like hearing and seeing an orca break the surface. But my dream, my whole life, has been to get in the water with them, be in their realm and see how they hunt, how they communicate.
Hunting is an important part of culture for orcas, and what may look like a series of disjointed movements of dorsals from the surface is something quite special underneath. Carousel feeding is a spectacular cooperative hunting method mastered by the Norwegian orcas to capture the herring. They start by surrounding a school of herring and herding them into a tight ball. They tighten this ball by blowing bubbles, flashing their white undersides and slapping their tails on the surface. They then move the herring toward the surface of the water. Some of the orcas begin to feed, while others maintain the bait ball. The feeding orcas whip their tails to stun and kill several herring at a time.
What makes this population of orcas so unique to any others?
A diet and the feeding. For me, the most fascinating is that this interaction with the other species, because that usually you cannot see anywhere else in the world.
These orcas used to be labeled type 1, type 2, and now they're under the umbrella of just the North Atlantic orcas because of dietary overlaps. So I guess now they're just primarily feeding on herring, but in other months, are they predating other fish, other mammals?
Yes, so these orcas who are feeding on the herring in the winter time, there are individual identified cases who are feeding on seals or other type of fish, not in the winter time, but the other months of the year.
Would you call this population thriving here?
Yes, I think so.
One of the growing concerns with these orcas is the interactions they're having with fishing vessels like these. These fishermen are hunting for herring, the same as the orca, and there have been a few instances where the orcas have become entangled in the fishing nets and died.
So we've just had a last minute offer to go and observe one of the fishing vessels at night out at sea. This is a really unique experience. Not many people get to see this up close, and this is when a lot of the orcas are surrounding the herring nets next to the boat. Steve, is this ever dangerous for the orcas when they're hunting like this and they're picking up the herring?
When the guys are actually putting the net out, it can result in some of the orcas being stuck in the net.
Has that happened before?
It has, yeah.
So is that something that kind of people here and fishermen are working together to try and prevent those instances from happening again?
I believe there's research going on which they're trying to come up with some devices to put on the fishing nets to actually repel the orcas.
Oh, wow.
To try and stop the orcas from coming.
Witnessing this population gathering in such huge numbers, socializing and feasting on the abundance of herring, despite their numbers being threatened by live captures and culling in the 80s, It gives me so much hope for other struggling populations. They are apex predators, built to survive in every ocean. They were here millions of years before us, and I have no doubt they'll be here long after.